A boat ride is still the safest, driest way into this Houston neighborhood where Judy Bott's house is being torn apart. Like an estimated 30,000 homes in this area, everything that was flooded has to come out. Toxic mold, which can lead to respiratory illness, grows fast. 10 days after Hurricane Harvey hit Texas, it's not a safe work environment. Volunteers wear masks and watch for broken glass and rusted nails.
We have to be very careful. Yeah.
You're going to make sure everybody working here gets a tetanus shot.
Well, I'm going to do my best. Yeah, I'm not going to give it to them, but I'm going to send them to get it.
Across the flooded street, Trish and Buddy Hagner say they'll get tetanus shots too. Mold is already growing on their discarded furniture, and they know there's more inside their walls.
We're a one-story house. It creeps up fast, and the longer it takes to get in and get approval for anything, the worse it gets.
Floodwaters could contain bacteria, dead animals, even diluted sewage. Any cut or bruise brings a risk of infection. And Houston's hot summer weather will make areas like this perfect mosquito breeding grounds, increasing the chances of West Nile virus, dengue, and other insect-borne diseases. And there are broader concerns outside the standing water and persistent flooding in residential neighborhoods like this one. The Environmental Protection Agency has identified 13 different Superfund sites, toxic waste sites, that have been flooded out or otherwise damaged by Hurricane Harvey. And the extent of the impact on public health or water quality at those sites simply isn't known. At the nonprofit Air Alliance of Houston, there's concern about increased industrial air pollution because petrochemical plants and refineries would have vented chemicals and gases before the storm for safety. There are fears, too, of more pollution as they start back up.
We know that it triggers asthma. We know that it triggers other respiratory illnesses. It can cause irritation of the eyes, the nose, the throat.
Doctors say the long-term post-Harvey health hazards are mental, not just physical. The storm affected everybody.
It didn't matter what socioeconomic background or status, it hit, you know, all of our neighborhoods. And it's going to be very stressful, and it's going to take quite a while for us to recover. So we're concerned about the mental health of our population, and there are resources out there for them.
It's clear the water will recede in a matter of days or weeks, but challenges to public health will persist far longer. Alan Schauffler, Al Jazeera, Houston.